ignition.
China's space endeavors began during the first climax of lunar exploration. In 1970, China successfully launched its first artificial satellite, Dongfanghong-1. Although China was a latecomer in the space race, it progressed at a staggering pace. In the next few decades, China's advancements in aerospace continued to astonish the world. In 1971, China launched a scientific satellite, Shijian-1. In 1984, China sent its first experimental geostationary communication satellite into space. In 1988, the meteorological satellite Fengyun-1 was launched successfully. In 1990, China's newly developed high-thrust carrier rocket, Long March 2 strap-on carrier rocket, successfully lifted off. Over 30 years of space exploration, the success rate of China's satellite launch exceeded 90%. The Long March rocket family expanded to include 12 variants, capable of delivering payloads up to 9 tons into low Earth orbit. In 2003, the Shenzhou 5 spacecraft carried astronauts into Earth's orbit and safely returned. These milestones indicate that China has built a complete technical system for space exploration. Looking back at the history of space exploration, China's next target became even clearer. That is, the moon.
China has caught up with the second climax of lunar exploration, which spans from the late 20th century to the early 21st century. During this period, China was fully prepared in terms of technology, science, and overall capability. Therefore, China participated in the second global wave of lunar exploration.
On January 23, 2004, the time to set sail had come. On this day, China formally launched its lunar exploration program and named it China Project.
Our central government had a clear vision that our lunar exploration should be building, demonstrating, and solidifying our aerospace capabilities. China, starting with Chang'e 1, has entered a new era of deep space exploration.
4, 3, 2, 1. Ignition.
Ignition.
Liftoff.
In 2007, China launched its first lunar probe, Chang'e-1. It successfully entered lunar orbit and took 120-meter resolution images of the entire moon. In 2010, Chang'e-2 followed, delivering the highest resolution images of the moon to date, with a resolution of 7 meters. The year 2013 marked a historic milestone. Chang'e-3 successfully completed China's first soft landing on the moon, deploying the nation's first lunar rover. It was the first lunar probe to make a soft landing on lunar surface in 37 years. China also became the third country to ever land a spacecraft on the lunar surface. During the 21st century wave of lunar exploration, China wasn't the first to declare its mission, but it was the first to land on the moon.
China's lunar exploration started late, but aimed high. Chang'e-1 achieved lunar orbit exploration. Chang'e-2 took the highest resolution images of the moon with a resolution of 7 meters, which is a record still unbroken. Chang'e-3 accomplished a safe and precise unmanned landing on Moon. Chang'e-4 contributed to global knowledge by landing on the far side of the Moon.
In 2017, China National Space Administration announced a new lunar exploration plan. The goal of the Chang'e-5 mission was to collect samples from the Moon and bring them back to Earth.
45 лет назад, 9 августа 1976 года, была запущена последняя советская автоматическая...
Since the Soviet Luna 24 mission in 1976, which returned 170.1 grams of lunar soil, humanity has yet to retrieve more lunar samples. Will China succeed in this endeavor? China is striving to become the third nation, after the US and the Soviet Union, to bring back lunar samples. Returning lunar soil samples is no easy feat, and one of the most critical challenges lies in the launch vehicle. The Chang'e 5 mission involved numerous complex operations, so the lunar probe had a more intricate design, larger dimensions, and greater weight. The total mass of the Chang'e 5 probe is 8.2 tons. Only a rocket with significant thrust can handle such a load. In preparation for deep space exploration, China began developing high-thrust carrier rocket in 2006.
The Long March 5 rocket is China's new generation carrier rocket. From the outset, we aim to design rockets for ambitious tasks, like building a space station, lunar landing, lunar and Martian explorations, and even reaching deeper into space. So, this rocket was destined to serve for such a mission from the very beginning.
Long March 5, China's latest high-thrust rocket, features a 2.5-stage design with 4 strap-on boosters. It stands about 57 meters tall. For diameter, its core stage is 5 meters and the boosters 3.35 meters. Each booster is equipped with 2 120-ton liquid oxygen kerosene engines. The 4 boosters provide 8 120-ton engines altogether, delivering a total liftoff thrust of over 1,000 tons. It has a payload capacity of 25 tons to low Earth orbit and 14 tons to geostationary transfer orbit. The Long March 5 ranks among the top in the world's active launch vehicles in terms of both high and low orbit payload capabilities. In July 2020, Chang'e 5 was transported from Beijing to Wenchang Space Launch Site. After a series of tests, the Chang'e 5 probe was set to ride China's most powerful rocket to the moon. It was a historic moment in China's space exploration. The nation's first mission to collect and return extraterrestrial samples began. After 16 years, Chinese Lunar Exploration Program was poised to reach new heights. On the launch tower, the Long March 5 carrier rocket stood ready.
"30 minutes to launch."
"Wenchang, roger that." "10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Ignition."
"Ignition."
"Liftoff."
Riding aboard the Long March 5 carrier rocket, China 5 probe successfully entered the translunar injection orbit. The mission ahead required China 5 to execute a series of unprecedented and highly difficult operations. Collecting samples, lunar launching, performing rendezvous and docking, transferring the samples, and returning to Earth. The round trip would span over 800,000 kilometers and take more than 20 days.
We already have a basic understanding of the Moon. But new endeavors always bring new challenges. The China 5 had 89 engines, countless operations and actuators were involved. At the stage of planning and finalizing, we knew it would be a high-risk engineering program.
Space exploration is among the most complex endeavors humans undertake. The rockets and probes used in lunar exploration are composed of tens of thousands of parts. The launch process involves countless procedures, generating an overwhelming amount of data. Even the smallest mistake can be catastrophic. Even if every component and procedure is flawless, the unknowns of deep space still pose numerous risks that could derail the mission. Between 1959 and 2017, humanity launched 132 lunar probes, with a success rate of around 50%. Any minor error can spell disaster. The Beijing Aerospace Flight Control Center, one of the most advanced flight control centers in the world, is responsible for the command, computing, data processing, and information exchange for Chinese lunar exploration program. Whether China 5 could complete its mission as planned after leaving Earth, as well as how to deal with issues that arise, depended on ground-based observations and instructions.
All units, please confirm status after setup. Lin Hai.
Tracking stations across China closely monitored each and every move of the China 5 probe. All data converged at the Beijing Aerospace Flight Control Center, where the final commands were issued.
The probe is operating normally.
Beijing confirmed.
The first task was lunar soft landing. Although China had executed a perfect lunar soft landing in former mission, the demands for China 5 this time were clearly higher, more difficult, and more stringent.
After about 112 hours of flight, the Chang'e 5 probe successfully entered lunar orbit.
The lander and ascender maneuvered into an elliptical lunar orbit, with a perilune of about 11 kilometers and an apoyune of about 190 kilometers, ready for powered descent.
On December 1, 2020, at 10:57 p.m., the China 5 probe initiated its descent.
Engines on. Descent begins.
At 11:11 p.m., the China 5 probe landed in the pre-selected landing area. Smooth landing, precise touchdown.
If the drill encounters a hard layer, it might fail.
Yeah.
We divided the lunar soil into 10 types. As long as it's within the soil types we've planned for, we can collect it.
The lunar sampling operation is about to begin.